We would really like to thank ON Marketing Agency for supporting us in tonight's event, and of course Orange Grove for hosting us. So we're here to talk about SEO, content, and voice search. And in order to do that, we have a very interesting and very knowledgeable lineup, which is consisted of Panos Apostolis and Lazaros. And we are very thrilled to have with us also Shira Abel, who is the CEO and founder of Hunter and Bart, and she will be joining us via a video conference. And altogether, we will talk about the new technologies and the voice search. Towards the end of the event, we will have a small workshop session in order to have a more practical essence to all the theory you'll hear in the beginning.
Thanks, Amalia. Now, is there someone here who doesn't speak Greek? Okay. Good to know. We try to do everything in English, or almost everything, I think. I just wanted to share this with you. I think most of us, or maybe, I don't know how many of you had the opportunity to watch Sundar Pichai, the CEO of Google, testimony at the Congress this week. One of the questions that the Congress asked him in order to understand how Google and how the search engine works was why, when someone Googles the word idiot, this guy's picture comes up literally everywhere. Okay, I don't quite remember what he replied, so I'm not at the position to share with you his opinion. But this is a very—I'm using it as a very, very simple example for all of us to remind ourselves what is SEO and how it works. SEO is all about user intent, and it's all about user thinking. So basically, this picture comes up after someone searches with the word idiot, simply because users have used this picture building content around this word. So this is what the guys are going to talk to us about tonight, and I'm sure that Shira's input will be more than valuable for everyone. I'm really, really happy because it's not really every day that we have someone from San Francisco working with very big brands to speak to our community. I'm aware that Shira has been invited as a speaker at the Content Marketing World last year, which is the most significant event on content marketing, and she was also invited as a speaker at the Next Web Europe. So I'm sure you will enjoy, and I'm sure we will all learn a lot from her. Okay, so enjoy.
Καλησπέρα. I have to say that I was prepared to do the presentation in Greek, and I felt very confident about it, about doing the presentation in Greek. And then just a minute ago, we had to change all of it. I have to apologize for the way that I speak English, I pronounce words, things like that. But on the other hand, we're going to be talking about SEO. And we do SEO every day, and we are in the office, we kind of love it, so it should be fairly easy for us to do it even in English. So, about me. First of all, I've been doing SEO for the last 14 years. I've started doing that while I was working in the UK, came back to Greece at the perfect time to do anything in Greece, and I've still been doing SEO because I love it. I believe it's one of the most amazing things that a website can do so that they can attract more traffic. It's almost traffic for free. So couple of years ago, I started on marketing. On marketing is a Google certified partner. We're doing SEO, we're doing AdWords. And one of the biggest things that you need to know about how we work is that we're based on, we're looking at data, we're looking at facts, we're looking at numbers, and we listen to opinions, we think about, we hear opinions, but this is not how we make decisions. Making decisions and opinions is not the safest and the best bet that the company can have, especially when it comes to growing their online presence. So this is part of my background and the kind of projects that I worked in and the kind of projects that we work as a team together. Some of the projects are Greek, some of the projects are Greek and targeting people internationally, so they probably don't even have a web page or a word in Greek. And we have some projects that are totally international. What all of them share is that in every case we're trying to create a great website with great content that is appealing to users, that it is interesting to users, and that people want to share, so that at the end of the day we can attract more links to the website. So what is SEO? I suppose most of you here know what is SEO, but in essence it is the kind of tasks that we put together in order to create quality traffic in a website and attract more visits from search engines in order so that at the end of the day a website ranks higher in Google. If I put it in just three bullet points, for me, SEO is not for me, but for every major website, and that's totally a fact. SEO is the biggest traffic source for probably any kind of big website in Greece, definitely, and loads of them internationally. If you ask most of the international brands, all of the brands that we know, if you ask them, what is your most important marketing tactic for 2019, their answer is going to be SEO and content marketing. A couple of months ago, the head of growth and user acquisition for HubSpot was in Athens. So it's a person that manages a team of 200 people. And when I asked him what's your most important thing for 2019, that's what he said. We're going to do even more stuff on content marketing, even more stuff on SEO. The fact also is that it is scalable. The more effort you put into that, the more results you get. So that's why people use it. Also, it has an exceptional ROI. The money that you put into that, you get way more times money from that than any other kind of traffic source. So that's the only part with the calculations in the whole presentation. What we have. If you're talking about e-commerce or any other kind of probably online business, how you make money out of any online business? You make it out of the kind of visits that you have on the website, the conversion rate, and the average order value. So you need more people visiting your website, you need to have as high conversion rate as possible, and then buy us the most expensive product that you can give them. Now, given that probably we cannot touch the kind of products that you sell, and conversion rate can be a whole different topic, this is where we're talking about today, how you can get more traffic on your website. Now, this is the result of SEO. How much does it cost? What does it take to do the SEO? And it's rather simple, at least, if you think it on a very basic level. Tech is creating a proper website for your content. Having the right CMS, the right kind of code on your website. That's the important stuff. The UX, UX design, mobile-friendly design, that's about it. The content part, marketing part means that you have content that is helpful to users, to visitors, to action people. And then it's the links tab. The links part is the most challenging probably part for most people to comprehend. It's something that takes a lot of effort. At the end of the day, it usually comes as a result of good content. Now, if you put all of this into place, which is just three basic parts, right? Create a good website in terms of content, of technology, have nice content on the website, and a few links. At the end of the at the end, you have an amazing website. You have a brand that has more stuff and better stuff than any other brand. Not a lot of websites pay attention to things like that. Not a lot of, most websites, most website owners create content once and then just leave it like that for the next couple of years and think that that's about it. Well, life is not like that. We need to update content on websites all the time. At the end of the day, this is the result that you get, and this is how you can see it from Google Analytics. Now, this is the case of a totally new brand that we worked with. And it's all started with zero traffic, nothing at all. Nobody knew about the whole website. A few months later, even here, it reached about 15,000 users per month visiting the website. Now, given that this website was was targeting people in the United States, we could come up with a calculation that said that if we wanted to attract this kind of audience, this kind of people to the website by paying AdWords, the cost that we would have for that would be $40,000 per month. That's about half a million.